It's important to know just basically how a car works. It's important to know how to cook a simple meal, fix a plumbing leak, or even to sew on a button. It's also important to know some basic things about science, literature, and history. It's also very important to know some basic things about the Bible. Regardless of what you believe about God or the Bible, it's good to know what's in it. You may be a religiously devout person, religiously curious, religiously confused, religiously apathetic, or even against religion entirely. It's still good to know what's in the Bible. To be informed about it is a good idea. It's just smart. There is a very strong case to be made that the Bible has its origin with God. But besides that, you need to know some basics about this very important, very impactful book. For instance, who was involved in the writing of it? Who were the audiences that received the original writings? Where did these writings take place? When did they take place? And if you pick up the Bible, how is it organized? You need to know that so you can navigate your way through it. So here are three good practical reasons why you need to know what's in the Bible. First of all, it is quality literature. For instance, there is this account early in the Bible about a man named Joseph. He had 11 brothers. He was favored by his father. His older brothers were incredibly jealous of him. As a result, they captured him, sold him to slave traders who took him into Egypt. Meanwhile, they went back to their father with bloody garments and implied to their father that a wild beast had killed Joseph. While back in Egypt, Joseph had climbed the ladder of servants and through a series of unusual events ends up favored by the Pharaoh, the ruler of the land, and eventually becomes the prime minister in Pharaoh's government. Many years later, a famine strikes Joseph's homeland. As a result, his brothers have to come to Egypt to buy food. And Joseph is the one who is the administrator on the sale of the food, of the grain. So his brothers have to come to buy food from him, but they don't know who he is. But he recognizes them, and then the story gets really interesting. Now listen to these words from a book called Ecclesiastes. I hated all my toil in which I toil under the sun, seeing that I must leave it to the man who will come after me. And who knows whether he will be wise or a fool? Yet he will be master of all for which I toiled and used my wisdom under the sun. This also is vanity. The same book also says, for everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. If you enjoy a good story, if you are inspired by stirring poetry, and if you benefit from wise counsel, then you need to know what's in the Bible. It's filled with these things, plus more. A second reason why it's important to know what's in the Bible is because it contains essential knowledge. You need knowledge about how to send an email, how to drive a car, how to get a stain out of your clothing. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about broader things, world citizen kind of things, cultural realities. For instance, who were the Jews? Who was Jesus called the Christ? What were the Ten Commandments? What are the ideas of heaven and hell? And what does it mean when one sports team is called the David and their opponent is called Goliath? To be culturally in the know, you need to know what's in the Bible. And here is a third reason why it's good to know about the Bible. And that's its claim. In 2 Timothy chapter 3 and in verse 16, It says all scripture is breathed out by God. What that means is that the writings of the Bible, though humans were used to pen the words, actually came from God, that God breathed or spoke them out. Think about what that means. If the Bible is from God, it provides a way to God and even to eternal life. You may struggle with accepting the idea that the Bible is a guide to God and a guide to eternal life, but consider this. Those subjects, those questions are too important not to investigate. So, let's learn more about what's in the Bible and how to understand it. Join me for more videos in this series, Bible 101.